Hi everyone, this is Smoothie. Welcome to QA Automation classes. Hope you are doing good. So let's continue with our functional programming sessions. So today I'm going to continue on the functional programming session. Like I told last class, we have completed the consumer. So let's continue, and today I'm going to cover buy, consumer and supplier. Okay, so let's see. Okay, so in the last session we saw the consumer, right? So consumer, what did it do? So the consumer, it took one argument, right? So like you have to specify what is the input type, okay, and it doesn't return anything. So it will accept that input type whatever you are passing, and then it will perform some operation, right? So that's what the consumer did. So similarly, buy consumer, right? So in buy consumer, we have to pass two argument, right? And the same, like it will accept both the argument and it will do some operation. It is not going to return anything, okay? So let's do a simple example, okay? So for this one, I'll say new class consumer example 3. So this is the example of buy consumer, okay? So the buy consumer is going to accept two arguments, right? So let's say buy consumer, okay? So two arguments it's going to pass. Let's say integer comma integer, okay? So two arguments, I'll say buy consumer, okay? Let me import it first. java.util.function, okay, equals to. So now I have to write the lambda, right? So since two things we have specified here, integer types, so we'll say a comma b, okay? So lambda, right? So here I'll say suppose I want to do the addition, right? So let's add and print, okay? See, so I'll say addition, okay, is something, I'll say plus, okay? So here actually I'll say a plus b, right? A plus b, right? So now this is the buy consumer I have defined. Now I have to call the buy consumer. The same thing, one consumer will use the accept method, buy consumer will also use the accept method. So let's take the reference bic dot accept, right? Dot accept. So now I have to pass two values, let's say 20 and 40. These two should be integer type, right? So now let's run it. So addition is 60. Then you see, guys. So here I cannot say like a comma b lambda a plus b, because it's not going to return anything, right? So here only whatever print or whatever you want to do, you do it here only, right? So this is the concept of the buy consumer, right? Hope it is clear, guys. And then we have one more left, okay? So that is called as the supplier. So what is a supplier? Okay, the supplier has the get method, okay? So it doesn't take any value but returns a value based on the calculation. So there are four things, right, guys? I just want to reiterate, okay? So predicate, right? In the predicate, what happened? So we had the one input type it took, and it always returned the boolean type, okay? And it has the test method. Then we came to the function, right? In the function, what we did? In the function, we had it took one argument, right? And again, we have to specify the return type, right? Guys? Yes. So, and then in the function, it has the apply method, right? So with the help of the apply method, we used to call that function, right? So that is the second one, function, right? And then the third one was the consumer, right? So in the consumer, what we did, in the consumer here, if you see the example consumer, the consumer will accept one input type, right? And it won't return anything, right? And then comes the supplier. In the supplier, what happens? The supplier it doesn't take any value, but it is going to return a value depending upon your calculation, right? So just see the supplier. Let me create one package. So what it's gonna do is it's not going to take any argument, okay, but it's gonna return something, right? Make sense, guys? So let's do that, okay? And the method here is the get method, okay? So let's define some supplier, okay? And let's take this one, local data time. So local data time is nothing but this is system time, then it will calculate. Okay. Local. Okay. Date time. Okay. So local data time, and I'll say okay S1. Okay, so equals to, let's write the lambda. So let me put this one first. Okay, so now let's write the lambda local data time. I think I have to import this one also. Java dot time dot local data time actually. Yes, local data time, right? Yeah. So this one equals to. So I'll say it doesn't take anything, right? So now I'll say. Local date time dot now, right? And let's print it, right? So okay, so I'll say S1 dot, we have to use the get method, right? So it will return a local date time type, right? So see, so supplier local date time, okay. So and I'm saying S1 equals to, it doesn't take any argument here, right? So no arguments are passed here, right? And local date time dot now, okay. For good dot semicolon. This one dot get, okay. Let's run this one. So now you can see this is my local date and time on my machine, okay. So similarly we can have the like multiple things, right? So I want to see one more example. Let's see supplier. Let's create one more supplier. Capsules supplier. So I'll say string type of value. Supply string, okay, and S2, right? So this is nothing but the return type, right? It is returning something, right? So here it is returning local data time. I'm not specifying input type, you guys are capturing, getting it, right? So the supplier, the value whatever I'm passing here, right? So I'm not passing, this is not the input type, this is the return type, right? So any type you want to pass, you pass. Okay, so here I am expecting a return type of the string, okay? So I'm saying S2 equals to, because since there is no return type, okay, into parentheses, and then I'll say just I want to print something, okay, hello world, okay, just I'm printing this one, makes sense? Now this is the string, okay? Now how to call, I'll say S2 dot sem get method, right? So now say the get method. So now run it. So you should see it is printing hello world. Okay? The hello world is getting printed. So this is the supplier. Okay. So there is no buy supplier. Okay. So So function at any point of time, it can only return only one value, right? So if there will be a bisupplier, that means it will return two values, right? So that is not possible in Java. So that's why there is no bisupplier here. Okay. So that is the important part. Okay. So we covered predicate. Okay. So let's do a quick recap. Predicate. Okay. So in the predicate, we have like one input type, and we used to call the test method. Okay. And the predicate. And then we came to the functions, right? And we have the bipredicate also. In the bipredicate, we take the two arguments, okay, and we do some operation. It used to return the value, right, boolean value. So when there is a condition checking, we go for the predicate or bipredicate. And then second one is a function. Okay, during the function, we have two things, right? One, we have to specify the input type. Another, we have to specify the return data type. Okay. And if you have some calculation or something to do, then it's better to go with the function. Okay. And in the function, we have one method called as the apply. Okay. And similarly, we have the by function. Okay. This one will be the by function. That. So in the by function, we took two input type arguments and one return type you have to specify. Okay. So when you have two operands, right, in that case you go with the by function, right? And similarly, we have to call the apply method, and then the consumer. Okay, so consumer, and in the consumer we have to specify what is the input type, right? And it doesn't return anything, right? So whatever operation you want to show or whatever you want to do, you do it, okay, there only inside the lambda only, whatever you are defining, because it is not going to return anything. So here I'm saying I'm defining a consumer of type string, and here only I'm saying the given string is this one and the length of the string is this one. So I have to call the accept method here, right? So that is for the consumer. So similarly, we have by consumer also, right? In the by consumer, it will take the two argument instead of one, and the exact operation will be done there. Whatever operation you want to do, do there. Okay, fine. And then there is the supplier. In the supplier, it doesn't take any argument. Moreover, it does some operation and return that value. So now in the supplier, we should always mention the return type. Okay. So supplier local date time is on local date time dot now. This example you knew, right? So now we have to call the get method, right? So with the get method, it is going to be called, right? And whatever value we are giving here, that is going to be get returned. If you see, it doesn't take any input argument, right? Here you can see it is blank always, right? So yeah, that's all to the different types of the predefined, right, functional interfaces available in the Java 8. So predicate, function, consumer, and supplier. Okay, so this would be sufficient for you to start with the functional programming with Java 1.8. okay, and in the next session I'm planning to have the combination of the different types of the things, like combination of the predicate and consumer, right, and maybe combination of the function, predicate, and consumer, right? So we'll see few example related to them. Okay, so that's all for today, guys. Okay, so thank you everyone for watching this video. Please do subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to get notified about new videos. So this is Smoothie signing off for today, with a promise to learn something new tomorrow. Have a good day. Bye. Thank you.